Off to Caldwin's Bridge, sir. We'll get our sleep later. Just climb aboard when you're ready. What do you think, Corvo? Caldwin's Bridge. You've been in the city for years, but you lived in Dunwall Tower with the late Empress, so maybe you haven't visited the bridge before tonight. Something to look out for. See all them lights on the water? That's right, we'll be spotted for sure. You're gonna have to shut off their power before I can pick you up. Now, about bringing Sokolov back alive, he's smart. Maybe even smarter than Piero. Got the whole of Dunwall under his thumb with all that natural philosophy business. New technology, potions, and the like. Seems dangerous to me. But what do I know? Here we are. I'll meet you at the arches under Sokolov's place when you're ready. Assuming the potions are taken care of.
Understand? Curfew means ain't nobody allowed to be wandering about.
Serve those orders.
Yeah, I know. But
if we do see something, then what? Do we say something? Remind them about curfew?
No. You don't remind them. You chase them down, and you give them a severely...
Okay, yeah, I got it. Severely deadly beating.
Did you hear Morris was dragged off by
overseers for some black magic nonsense?
Please.
Citizens and visitors to our city, by order of the Regent, the curfew is now active. No foot traffic is allowed across Caldwin's Bridge until curfew is lifted. Attention all citizens, no pedestrian movement is allowed along Caldwin's Bridge during this period. Curfew will end tomorrow morning at sunrise.
Thank you. curse the plague and this blasted curfew. How is anyone supposed to make a living?
Well now, Mr. Pratchett. Now, Mr. Pratchett.
Even a wealthy man like you needs the city watch.
Gangs are cutting throats and smashing windows left and right, and the weepers, excuse me, the plague victims are worse. Are you saying the Lord Regent is wrong
for imposing curfew?
It won't do you any good to bait me, officer. But don't worry, I'll be fine. A smart man can come out of here even in time.
Sure, like that Sokolov. He's doing fine. Always a lot of exotic items coming in.
Rivers change course over many lifetimes, and eventually all bridges tumble down. 1,000 years ago, there was another city on this spot. The people carved the bones of whales into runes and inscribed them with my mark. Children still find them washed up in the river mud. Anton Sokolov has made a great study of my runes, but he's not special like you are. He wasn't chosen, and he doesn't wear my mark. So he can't unlock their secrets. Sokolov believes there are specific words and acts that can compel me to appear before him. He searches old temples in Pendicia and ruined sub-basements in the flooded district. He performs disgusting rituals beneath the old abbey. But if he really wants to meet me, he could start by being a bit more interesting.
Let's just see what happens.
No time to blow a cloud. We got somebody about.
Love watching them turn and turn.
What, wheels?
Yes, round and around, like a cycle of life.
Such a wondrous symbol of progress.
If you say so, and remember, Gardner, you must make sure they keep turning. It would look very good.
Find a way to keep these rats off me so that I can get out. Take care of the rats, please. stop that. Thank you for helping me. I thought it was safe. There were rats. So many rats, completely infested. I know some folks aren't superstitious, but I swear, the rats showed up after a man came through, waving around an amulet of some kind. It looked like it was made of bone. But he's dead now, like the others who were living here.